Hey guys, it's Peter. Today I'll be going over the number 12 most popular kata or code challenge on Codewars. This problem is called counting duplicates. So we need to write a function that will return the count of distinct case-insensitive alphabetic characters and numeric digits that occur more than once in the input string. The input string can be assumed to contain only alphabets, both uppercase and lowercase, and numeric digits. Alright, basically we need to go by the title of this problem and count how many unique characters are duplicated in the text. Let me show you a solution that I believe is the most straightforward and efficient in Python. After that, I will go through a few variations for this solution to give you a few options when faced with any similar problems. Finally, I will explain the time complexity of the top voted solution on Codewars, since there seems to be a lot of misunderstanding. Okay, so for our solution, we will break the problem down into two steps. Step 1, we need to tally up how many times a character is being repeated in the text. We can do this very easily by utilizing the counter object in the built-in collections library. But remember, we need to convert text to lowercase because we are counting case-insensitive characters. Okay, for step number 2, we simply need to loop through the unique characters in our counter dictionary. If the character count is greater than 1, then we increment our total. And then of course, we can return the total at the end. And that's it! Now, depending on your preferences, there are a few different ways we can create our counter dictionary. First, if we don't want to use any built-in libraries, it is simple enough to use a regular dictionary and then a for loop to do the counting. Another way we can do this is to use the default dict object in the collections library. This way, we don't have to set our own default zero value with the get method. The default dict object will do that for us. So instead of writing counter.get and then +1, we can simply do a += 1. Okay, now let's take a look at the top voted solution. We can see that there are quite a few comments that say this solution has a quadratic or O of n squared time complexity. So to try and analyze the time complexity easier, let's convert this list comprehension back to a regular for loop. So this is the exact same algorithm, but expanded out. Okay, first, let's define n to be the total number of characters in the input string s. So first, the s.lower will be executed. The lower string method needs to iterate through every single character in order to convert them into lowercase letters. This means it takes O of n time. After this is done, it will take another O of n time to convert the string into a set. So currently it is n plus n. Now that we have our set created, this for loop expression will execute. But how many total times will it iterate? Well, the set will contain strictly unique characters. The problem states that there will only be alphanumeric characters. And remember, we converted the string to lowercase. So since there are only 26 letters in the English alphabet and 10 digits from 0 to 9, the set will have at most 26 plus 10 or 36 unique characters. This 36 is a constant because it does not depend on the size of the input string. S could have 100 characters or 10,000 characters or even a billion characters. This set will still at most have 36 unique characters. This means our for loop will loop at most 36 times. Okay, so let's see what the time complexity is for each iteration. We are doing a s.lower, so that takes O of n time. And then we do a count. Now this count will also need to iterate through every single character in the s string. So this will take another O of n time. Now let's do some basic algebra to simplify this expression. Okay, so overall, we know that this solution will take roughly 74 n time in the very worst case. Now when we use big O notations, we don't really care about the coefficients. This means that the overall time complexity is simply big O of n, and not n squared or quadratic. Now, does this mean this top solution is the most efficient solution? No, definitely not. There are far more efficient solutions for this problem. For instance, the solutions I provided only take 2n time instead of 74n. But in terms of asymptotic behavior, they are both considered big O of n time algorithms. Alright, and that's it. I hope I was able to help you understand the time complexity analysis. If you have any questions about this problem or about Python, please let me know in the comment section below. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next coding video. Thanks.